Hopefully everybody can see this image. If not, tell me. If you guys are having trouble seeing that, I can try to make it bigger. You guys see it okay back there? Okay. So basically what that chart shows, that those are all the hormone activities that are going on during our programming process. And I think this is, we get a lot of questions about what happens if the shot schedule's off, or why do we do the timing the way we do, or what is this hormone doing, and things like that. So I wanted to put this up here and then leave it a little bit open for what you guys want to talk about. All right, so the dotted line in the middle, that's progesterone. And so the cedar is going to release that progesterone product. And so that's the synthetic progesterone that we're gonna give them. There at the bottom is estradiol. And so it goes low and then it spikes up. So when those animals come into heat and they stand to be mounted, that is the estradiol in their system. That's the estrogen that's causing them to be receptive to the male. If you look at, there's a little spike, a little dotted spike, real kind of up and down on those images over there. That's what's called, labeled as PGF2 alpha. So that's your luteolize or your estramate is what we're using in place of that spike in the chart. And then we kind of have this square box that comes up. That's LH, that's the luteinizing hormone. And so that's a part of that release of the ovum, release of the egg. And so if you notice that release of the egg and estrus, or heat, correlates together, and then ovulation happens shortly thereafter. So Donnie, when you breed cows and you're checking heats in the pasture, how long after standing heat do you breed a cow?
They start standing heat 12 to 18 hours a little later.
12 to 18 hours later. So that correlates with this chart. If you look over here to the left, you see estrus and ovulation is kind of right after that. So that insemination is happening closer to ovulation and after estrus. You know, so one of the real common questions that we'll get within our clients is, well, why are we breeding at this time? She was in heat yesterday. She was in heat last night. Those kind of things. So that comes back into trying to time out this ovulation component.